Scuba Scoop is sponsored by
Yo, people, check this out. I have a story I want to tell. Once upon a time, which was today, I walked into studio and I noticed I only had my rings on and I didn't have any extra jewelry. So my new camera person, Michael, he whipped out one earring, ladies and gentlemen. One earring from his bag. Michael, njagala ombulire no earring yavuddewa ate kola chimunsa woyo. Emu. So, in honor of this one earring, I'm going to do the show with this one earring on Temunyiga. We just want to do things like this. Other than that, my name is Tina Fierce One. It happens to be a beautiful Wednesday. I am not crushing on anyone. Michael, do you have any woman you're crushing on today? That one doesn't count. You already married her. Anywho, welcome. The show is Scoop and Scoop. It's proudly sponsored by Coca-Cola. About to wave you don't want to during COVID. I actually could have come here today and told all of you different, like, olugambo jeruli, make olugambo tonarula. Olugambo jeruli kala sirwerunji nyoluli yao. Nakambia kanso kenteke olugambo lino ansi. And let us get it. Let's get to talking about Prophet Elvis Mbonye. Now, for all of you who have been watching this show for quite some time, you know how much I hate a scam artist. But most importantly, you know how much I hate any thief that is trying to masquerade under the ministry. I hate it. It bothers me. It irks me because if I meet another mlokola, at times I feel it is too soon because of people like this. Anywho. So, we thought him coming out and telling us he knew about COVID-19. He got the prophecy, decided not to tell us because he felt, dig this, we would not understand him. Did he say we would not understand him or he felt we would not? Biali biamu moyo. Jesus is the Lord. Abi, I spoke on that one. Like, that was not disrespectful enough, ladies and gentlemen. This dimwit, this lumpen, this guy with the receding hairline, this trick. Because for me now, it's like he's turning tricks. He took the time out to sit with Sewanja. Is it Sewanja? I think they wanted to expound on that same prophecy because everybody has been making noise. Those are 24 minutes of my life I am never getting back. Those are minutes that could have probably benefited this nation here, that could have benefited the entertainment industry. But 24 minutes of my life I wasted watching that interview will never, ever, ever be given back. Jesus is the Lord. My goodness, Jesus riding on a chariot. Mbonye. When Mbonye sits down, he looks at us poor Ugandans and is like, "La mbata zino." Like, what goes through Mbonye's head? What? Is he so high up on his mixed crazy juice that he doesn't even see that we see? I want to understand. I do, people, I do. Because when I watched the first video, if you know a thing or two about reading body language, when you watch the first video where he was in a blue chair with a blue suit on, I remember the colors. That's how much this guy pissed me off. He couldn't sit in one place. Anyway, I don't want to you know what? Anyway, he sat down with Sewanja and he said certain things.
I remember one of the prophecies that I got was this that we are now facing. I got that there would come a virus from China that would affect people. It was as simple and as straightforward as that. Now I sat down after I was looking through the prophecies that had been given to me, and that one, I developed a habit where I, whenever I receive something prophetically, I look at it and I want to remove all kind of biases to help someone who is really carnal, who operates carnally, and that they may not have any unbelief or something. So when I saw it, I said, okay, what if someone thinks that, oh, there's been viruses before, you know, flu viruses before in China, and I'm giving this one, they think that this is related to that, and they'll miss out on the prophetic gist. So I decided, no, I'm not going to prophesy this. It's among the several prophecies I didn't give in January.
But Mbonye, oh, Mbonye told us that it is upon the prophet's discretion to reveal a prophecy. I want to beg the question. So if it's upon the prophet, guys, I'm confused. Because this guy came out and in this very interview, he's like, no, I did actually have to tell people though I got the prophet. Then I'm like, but then who is a prophet? I thought that the reason why we have prophets is because God decided not to come back, you know, to come in all his might and his glory. He decided, let me put my peoples there to tell my peoples what they should be doing. Then Mbonye comes out and he tells us, I knew, but I said no. Yo, dig this. That makes Mbonye our modern day. He's like our modern day Jonah from the Bible. Jonah is the only person in the Bible, only man that God personally told him, go here. And Jonah was like, nah, I ain't going. Mm-mm. He was swallowed by a fish. So Mbonye also did the same. God told him, go and tell my people there is COVID-19 coming. And he was like, no. I was listening to this cat trying to explain his nonsense. People, I don't care if Mbonye is your papa, your grandfather, if he sleeps under your bed, if you kiss his feet, if he kisses yours back. I do not care what this man is to you in your life. I need for you to understand that this guy is such a joke. This guy has sat down and mastered the art of looking at you and saying, oh, these dimwits have nothing to do better with their time. Kamba siru walireko. Mbonye, in this same interview, quoted scripture that was off. Kabidiyo ngenda kabalaga. He quoted scripture, even put a verse there, simanya Thelosian, simanya verse this. When we looked it up, it is saying totally different from what he said.
Again, Jesus said, Jesus said there's a lot. He said, there's a lot of scripture. Jesus said, John chapter 1, verse 12, he says that, he says, if I've told you earthly things and you have not believed, how will you believe if I tell you heavenly things?
Then I called a couple of people in ministry because Mbonye uses this whole thing called we of canon knowledge. Fetuliba canon knowledge. Obaka gambo baka mu yigidiza bu yigidiza. Even his stupid followers, his remnants, use that nonsense because he has mastered the art of telling them, if you think outside the box, if you use logic, you are of canon mind and of canon knowledge. Na yembwene chaba ba. Woo, child. No wonder Kabuleta had to actually side by this guy, because I think Kabuleta was like, wait, this guy is actually a scam artist. I want in on this. And he joined in. So for me, Kabuleta, the remnants, his followers, his wife, children, all of them are involved. They're all scam artists. They're all thieves. And you idiots, every week, Baba Saba sent, hey, oh, we want to buy the prophet a Range Rover. My Jesus was walking on foot. Negro walked through a full town on a donkey. This dimwit though has preferences. His God told him to prefer Mercedes and Range Rover. His God told him, Abraham should dress you up and Louis V should be on your feet. What is this curry? What is this tomfoolery? Like, never dance is saying, ngenda kuvuma Mbonye bintu chikumi. Nga chikumi. I was like, another thing that bothered me about this particular interview, he goes like, you see, at the end of every year, we sit and we have a meeting where I talk about prophecies for the next year. I'm like, wait, Zoe Ministries has an AOB. Jesus. So at the beginning of the year, he's like, gather around, children, gather around, gather. So Dalada said COVID-19 will come around February, but we are not going to tell them that, because in that same interview, they asked him, so why would you keep quiet, yet you have a very huge following of people? Why would you keep quiet about something like that? And this man says, like, no, 'tis upon my discretion to tell people what has been prophesied. I was like, so namwe, aba mulabidira, aba wadeyo, mufe. What did I tell you about this corona ish? It's going to show so many things. I'm seeing well-renowned pastors in America have now resorted to saying, corona, boo, go. What the hell? And you people are still here with so much faith in Mbonyi. Who is Benny Hinn when you need him? Has anybody had Benny Hinn say jack? Anything. But you're here believing in Mbonyi. Who wants to believe Mbonyi anyway? Who is supposed to believe Mbonyi? Because I feel even his remnants can see the bullshit, but they keep waiting and they're like, you see, he said my breakthrough is coming like next week. So I can't abuse him, but what? What? Why do you people let this? Why can't we hold these people accountable? That's my question. Even I have come here to sit, vent, and rant, but apart from me telling you, Mzuku K, stay woke, Mzuku K, I don't think I'm doing much. I'm just like the rest of you who are coming on social media and just, you know, saying, Mbonyi wakali, Mbonyi mbwagwe, Mbonyi, Mbonyi, Mbonyi. Let's hold this guy accountable for this tomfoolery. Ojute kun national television no to bulira gasiango. How? Like, how? Uganda, what's wrong with you? But you see, again, as much as I want to shout and scream and cut call, we have to put some respect on Mbonyi's name. Ask me why. Why? Abi, do you know how much knowledge it takes and patience to fool a crowd of over 3,000 people for the past how many years into giving you their money? And yet to know you're doing nothing. You think it is easy to run a full scam on a country like that? This guy is smart. He's too smart. Let's actually give him that. Now that makes you, the remnants, the most stupid human beings to ever grace the surface of this earth. Even my three-year-old will probably look at you and go like, if Dam Dam was a person, Muliba Siru. Muliba siro wangwa buba tu demu bukunku mkabuti. Katitinda kweno episode egendo kwe ogenda jiwanika. Mujaku timeline muasame mwa mwa temuina na chakulia. Temuina na chakulia. Corona abatwala. Enakweva likeva kuteva vunze vunze. Your pastor is out in a 5-star hotel to himself. They are running and screaming that his beck and call. Mulia yenjale bata muliku. He told me my outcome is coming soon. Mbwamwe. Abasajja angaba nobeba nasobola post-COVID. Because he has saved enough off of your behinds. He has. When Kabuleta comes here and he tells you, ay papa, ay baba, le. No yagala mugamba genda weba kenei mchitana na chotu chimanye. Do you know why he's doing that? Do you know why you have all these guys trying to hype him up? Because they, when they see you guys hype him like idiots, about in the upper, you know, the upper cluster, the lower remnant is going to have no choice but to believe it. So Kabuleta cannot risk not getting money in his pocket, because how will the other remnant who doesn't want to pull his money out of the pocket get the idea? So all he has to do is say, it's a success, I am living good, I have this, I have this. Poor remnant on the side, you also bring Yoka 400K Nyamaref. I think we need to try to do one thing. We need to understand religion is not salvation. Faith is your salvation. Now, whatever you have faith in, that should lead you to salvation. It is not written anywhere that it had to be a religion. Because even Jesus Christ broke free from religion. He was just a passing wonder, teaching, and, you know, he was just telling people there is a God above somewhere. But if you keep this nonsense, this guy stood on TV, national television, Nagamba, he has met Lucifer and Lucifer fears him. You are joking. Hey, hey. Mbani, please tell me Lucifer's features, because I have a new book I'm going to write, like the one Shadows Angel. Wait. Do you think Mbonye's Lucifer will look the same way as the one that Roger Mgisha? They have their own version. But I thought, since it is one Lucifer and it is one God and one Jesus, this is a film. Oh, Uganda, wake up. Muchaka, baby, zibu biamwe. You have a bad president. You have bad roads. You keep crying. You keep complaining. But you are not going to go anywhere if all of you keep letting tricksters like this man waltz amidst you and just do whatever the heck they want to do. If you still keep religion as a tank. Muganda bona bona. Look at all the other countries that actually don't put so much issue on religion. Do you know what Muzungu yabareka? He came. He knew you had diamonds. He came. He gave you the Bible, took the diamonds. He is rich, you have the Bible. Same exact thing. That's what prophets do. They are no different from the missionaries who came eons of years back. It's the same thing. They come, give you the faith of the Lord, and then they rob you clean. You can actually, Kati, mubadete musabazi no week yeziwede. Are you going to say that God has not listened or heard your prayers because you did not sit with your different pastors? Are you going to tell me that God is not going to work miracles in you because you did not sow a seed? Are you going to tell me that God will not see you through this next coming time because you did not tithe? Tithe what? You're not working. You're supposed to give a tenth of your earnings. Where are you earning? But your pastors are outrightly telling you, send mobile money. Muriba siru. Embwezo muzigambe zisituke zigende zinonye mirimu. You have become their job. You get the little money that you have, give it to them for sustainability, and then the rest of you muribona abona. It's the same example I was giving about, I went to Wujingo's church. When you see the people seated in that crowd, enakwe kukwata. Enakwe kukwata mkazi nga inaka, nakamukali wana kalakali wano yaza atambula. Tanalia naksatu. Neba ise chibembweyo nekwate nkumi tan. Ezandi badezi davidide umanawe. Naziteka mkabbo. Bujingo nga gamba, wahoho. Susan jantu gende nkugulide Land Rover. The Land Rover. Nga museka. Mukama yebazibwe, yebazibwe. I don't care if any of you thinks I am attacking the Lord. No, I need for you people to discern. I need for you to learn how to discern. Understand what religion is. Understand what faith is. If you do that, you're going to be independent souls. Not, have you people noticed that Mbonye's people look like as if they were hypnotized? I think whenever he does that thing, this is a live broadcast from heaven. There's something in the air. They get drunk on his. How are you going to believe a guy whose own hairline jumped to believe him? It left him. How? How? How are you going to believe a guy? I mean, we all have a past. We've partied, we've drunk, we've done. Don't even act like you don't have a past. All of us here have a past. But did y'all see that guy's past? That was some ghetto-ish. Now, it's easy to take a man out the ghetto, but you can't get the ghetto out of him. And it's the ghetto that gives birth to all the most brilliant plans. Guess what? Zoe Ministries was a plan that was birthed in front of a kaboto of Bond 7, a full cavera of Mira, and a big EG. Batula, Nebaba Fumba, Nebaba Yiya, years down the road, Embwene Echabaliko. Echabaliko. Have any of your churches given back to you? Mbonye, you keep asking these guys every week to ask for money, 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 money. What have you done for your remnants? I know two remnants who are sleeping in a kazigenja leba kala kateba kolo kutateba ina chakola. Bali ba manjira kujaku zoe ku Tuesday. Babu zabu zembera. And that's a sad thing. Do you know the biggest number of people who go to Zoe Ministries? I think the government should actually even imprison it. Like they should put this guy in prison. Because the biggest number of people that show up at this guy's church are very, very able-bodied, unemployed youth. Now, here is what Balokole churches all over try to sell. Yes, again and many times again, kutulamu, it is the truth. Whether you're getting angry or not, Balokole to have a good demo, COVID later binge. So, you go to this church, a very unemployed youth. Usually what takes these unemployed youths to church is they're looking for something that will work. I've looked for a job, I have failed. You're not begun. Let me go to Christ. When they go to Christ, they are spending half of their productive time in front of Christ. But he's not Christ. It is in front of your pastors, because you go to these churches from dusk till dawn. You want me to tell you the truth? I know it because I lived through it. My baby father started like that. Educated man. He ended up starting going to church from morning till evening. Natandika tugenda kunsozi. Netuvayo kunsozi netukiria mkama netumkwata muntegetege wetuti. Guno gwaka. Hachamu yita. Taina cheyafunye. So you spend all your productive time in front of a church. They are going to ask you to use your skill or somewhat, because they always give you work to do in the church so that you can feel a part of a community. And before you know it, you're going to just be living for the church. You'll be there 1 year, 2 years, 3 years, 4 years. Ngacheba kugamba chali chimu jangwe eri mukama ogenda funa omulimu. Nsobola kubalira abantu abamaze obudde mu church. Balinda mulimu. Miaka kumi nesa tuachari muli ya tude mkama tanampuli le mama. Where do people make out God to be deaf and mute? That he can't say nothing from here for himself? He has to send us a guy like that? No. The Lord speaks. He speaks through me. He speaks through you. He speaks through the bats. He speaks through nature. He's even speaking through COVID. Have your own faith, people. Leave these tricksters alone. But anyway, these are my humble thoughts. If you think I'm being too negative, you all need to listen to what his fellow pastors have to say.
Banabi neba kabona ababuli ngeri ne yenge ngeri gebe isam otya nokutya obanga tukyali n'entiisa y'ekibi. Abamu batu seno kugamba tya kana kaukanze nakabagamba nakamanya danuga tunuga yali mukisa.
Actually, when I hear this man called Mbonyo, Mbu Prophet Mbonyo, this charlatan, this fraudster, claiming that God told him that Corona was coming about a year ago, but then he did not prophesy because he never thought it important, then I look at a fool and I see a very, very typical fool and fraudster who keeps on lying, thinking everybody is a fool.
It's always nice to have that I told you so moment in life. I do that all the time. I do. So please, dear remnants, @TinaVS1, as always, is my Twitter handle. Ah, please, remnants, on Facebook, it is scoop on scoop. Don't miss a beat. Come at me. Oh, come. Ooh. Come at me. Mbongerendala. @TinaVS1 on Twitter. Scoop and Scoop on Facebook and the Tina Fierce One. Two full Facebook pages. Temwe kwa sambwe muteba malamu yuzoku mvumida kuzombi. And on YouTube, please, slide into those comments. I saw all of you in Sewanja's comments, all using the same line. Kano mind mbwa mwoluzungu luchaba zanya. Hit me up on the YouTube section too. And then you can get us on what other platform can we give them? My Instagram, yay, @TinaFierceOne with an H, and on Snapchat, if you dare, if you're bold, if you're brave. Yes, on Snapchat is still TinaFierceOne. Petty Betty has left the building. I'll catch you on the flip side. I'm not telling you to wash your hands. You know what time it is. You either want to die or you'll wash your hands. Musaleo. I'm out. Peace.
Scoop and Scoop is sponsored by